We heard that we are systemically racist. Now we heard that America is founded in lies and evil. I mean, that's what we've been told. We're proud to live in a country that liberated slaves.
Wait, what? So apparently you can get on the stage at CPAC and say just about anything. United States Senator Josh Hawley, who represents Missouri, went to CPAC and openly stated that America liberated the slaves. We liberated the slaves. Who is the we? What America are you talking about? The same America that put the slaves in slavery to begin with? That America? Are we just at the point that we're completely rewriting history and giving no regard to actual historical narratives and the value therein? In his speech, Josh Hawley conveniently and conspicuously left out the Civil War, which is America's bloodiest and deadliest conflict over the right to literally own other people. We also have seen narratives being changed across America as in yet another school joining the list of institutions that were assigning students critical thinking exercises around slavery. This one required that the students pen a letter to their families back in Africa and talk to them about what slavery was like in America. Not so coincidentally, a group of teachers from Missouri, Hawley's home state, are playing human Scrabble and spelling out a racial slur. This is not by accident. This cannot be attributed to simply not knowing. This is not a matter of ignorance or being unaware. This is the willful and intentional infliction of psychological and emotional damage to Black people, specifically Black children. And get this, that school is absolutely not the only one. But you want a letter? Okay, I'll give you a letter. Couple questions before we start though. Number one, how am I actually writing this letter given that reading and writing were both illegal for enslaved Africans and punishable by death? Second, who am I actually writing the letter to because I've been disconnected from my family and torn apart from my relatives? Still, I'm gonna give it a go. Dear Baba, that's Yoruba and Swahili for dad, by the way. I'm sorry it's taken this long to send you a letter. Given that I'm unable to legally learn to read or write, and both are punishable by death, it's quite possible that this may be the last time you ever hear from me. I also apologize for penning this in English. But because we have intentionally been stripped of our language, culture, identity, and religion, I have no way of writing you in our native tongue. Of course, that is also by design, but enough about that. I wish to clarify a few ideas about our life here in America. I've heard that people have said that whites came to Africa to steal slaves and take them to America for free labor. As you may suspect, this is not true. Europeans came to Africa for people, not for slaves. And they kidnapped people. They did not kidnap slaves. Human beings, who were doctors, teachers, and scientists, and forced them into hard labor as slaves without pay through violence. The owner of the plantation that I live on is married to a woman named Karen. Now, she is a piece of work. At night, she attempts to lure my friends and me into bed. But during the day, she accuses us of things that we didn't do. She seems unsure as to whether she prefers to hypersexualize Black bodies for her own erotic fetish or blame Black men for all of her shortcomings in life. This institution of forced labor through chattel slavery in America is setting up a dual-track structure of systemic oppression that on one hand will make America one of the wealthiest nations in the world, while simultaneously creating systemic inequity, generational poverty, mass incarceration, police brutality, intentional systemic disenfranchisement, achievement gaps in education, and various forms of physical, psychological, and economic violence against me and my descendants for the next several hundred years. Because of this, my friends and I have decided to use the brand of violence that we have learned from these people and revolt. We cannot reason with our oppressor, and we are done trying. However, I have but one request. If I meet my demise in the course of our fight for freedom, and you are told that I would have wanted peace and to remain calm, do not listen. Burn this bitch to the very last ember. This is my final wish and what I would have wanted. Sincerely, Charles. There's your fucking letter.